better, but it's too bright behind you.
Thank you, Shaini, for directing this so beautifully.
Shaini, Shaini, kar raha tha. Wo shoot ke
liye. I'll slap you. Okay. One. Tight slap will go through this phone. Nee, this is such a better frame.
Let's all give credit to Shaini for this. Nee, so ye bolti jayegi. I agree. I love you.
He's slimy recording all of this.
What do you mean slimy recording? I have to record this.
Oh shit.
Yaar, Vinay, ek khadoos Delhi wale ka role hai. Please kar lo.
Vinay, of course, was a natural. You know,
natural khadoos, Delhi
land. Will, Vinay. Bahar will. Is window se bahar. Hi, this is Shaini.
Namaskar, main Vinay Pathak.
Hi, I'm Lynn Lysham.
Hi, my name is Nicholas Karkumar.
And you are watching...
Aur Batao.
Aur Batao.
Aur Batao.
Aur Batao. Stuti ke saath.
शो का नाम है और बताओ मेरा नाम स्तुति एंड यहाँ पे अखूनी इज द नेम ऑफ द फिल्म जिसके बारे में बात करने आ रही है पहले तो आई नीड टू बी टोल्ड डिड आई प्रोनाउंस इट करेक्टली
राइट देयर ऑलमोस्ट देयर
Almost there. Okay. And I have Team Akuni here. So we have Nicholas Karkangar, the director. We have Shaini.
Yay!
Vinay Pathak, inke liye bhi zordar taaliyan. And Lynn Lysham.
Yeah, mera naam jab bol rahe the, tabhi baat kar raha tha.
And Shaini Gupta!
And Lynn Lysham! Baki theek hai.
What do you mean, sorry? I'm very glad that this has happened. So, I'm happy we're having this conversation after I have seen the film. So, I saw it last year at Mami. And, you know, this is, of course, I think, relevant at any given point of time, more so now when the world is, you know, talking about racism and you're talking about othering certain people in your own country. And at a time like this, do you expect with an online release, even though we're, you know, in the middle of a pandemic, would platforms like Netflix or the OTT platforms help you reach a wider audience when your subject is, you know, slightly different from what we are used to from mainstream Bollywood?
Yeah, because everyone's sitting and watching Netflix now anyway. And while the plan was originally for us to do a theatrical release, yeah, you know, like with most films, because there's just the magic of the big screen, which is wonderful to sort of be part of. The truth is that after the lockdown started, we just realized that, you know, this was the best way to go. And I think it's not, we're not cutting corners, or it's not a shortchanging of anything. This is a great time because of just how the world is, and the fact that it's coming out now on the ATT platform, on the OTT platforms, where a lot more people can access it, as opposed to a theatrical release, where again it's a little difficult for everybody to actually, you know, sort of go to the screens, to the theaters, is a wonderful thing. So,
Vinay Pathakji, congratulations! It's a Chintu ka birthday. It's a lovely performance and a lovely film.
Thank you.
And isme aap ekdam typical Delhi wale landlord ke role mein. How is it?
I have to blame my my dear friend and the director of this film, Mr. Nicholas, who did stereotype casting and called me and said he ek yaar Vinay ek khadoos Delhi wale ka role hai, please kar lo. मैंने कहा यार निकलेस तू कहता है कि मेरी फिल्म में एक छोटा सा रोल है कर लो तो भी कर लेता मैं लेकिन आपको मेरी याद आई कि एक खड़ूस दिल्ली वाले का रोल है मैंने कहा चलो अच्छा है कम से कम कोई तो कैरेक्टर है उसके अंदर
When Vinay Pathak is there is probably because of the way I look because yeah. This was something that completely reverses what we are used to because we used to seeing Sorry. People from the Northeast getting these tiny very stereotypical roles actually
I'm sorry.
मतलब ये जो मक्खन का पैकेट लेके धना धन मेरी तरफ फेंक रही है ना शायनी
थैंक यू वेरी मच. लेकिन मैं कह रहा हूँ ये जितना बाकी का मक्खन बचा है ना निकलस के लिए रखो तुम.
लिन रियल लाइफ में तो खड़ूस इस तरीके के लैंडलॉर्ड से बहुत पाला पड़ा होगा आपका.
नॉट too much actually. I grew up in Bombay, not I grew up but I studied in Bombay, so Bombay is completely different from Delhi, I feel.
You think it's
and yeah, any day. I love Bombay and I have really hard time whenever I travel to Delhi.
ये नया टूर्नामेंट शुरू किया इसने दिल्ली वर्सेस बॉम्बे.
No and luckily I've had great landlords so far and they were very nice to me and I lived in one apartment for 8 years, so that says a lot about how people are in Bombay.
And Bombay is also a lot more cosmopolitan, you know, but even in Bombay, like
more
you were talking
accepting.
About it.
Yeah,
and
you know,
and
Bombay
people mind their own business.
Moments, okay, Delhi isn't that bad.
No, absolutely. And I'm coming to that. Some of my
This is my personal experience. This is my personal experience.
Feeling it like
I didn't know.
Personal attack on Delhi. Personal attack. Suti, तुम्हारे दिल में पता क्या क्या होता है? एक मिनट. Delhi में पता क्या होता है?
अरे, but Bombay में भी होता है. मैं वही बोल रही हूँ कि मेरे दोस्त है जो नॉर्थ से है. मतलब हम मॉल में पैलेडियम जैसे मॉल में हम लाइन में खड़े पिक्चर देखने के लिए और somebody will come and ask my friend, oh, you're from Korea? Or you're Japanese? And in Bombay, and that also happens, right? And these are like, you know, well-to-do, educated, obviously, but the level of ignorance is everywhere.
I also saw in the film that it's not an us versus them narrative. You know, you're talking about the problems within every community and how we've internalized it, stereotyping or othering.
Yeah. I mean, I was very clear about that from the very start, and it's something that I wanted to get right. The fact that it's not pointing a finger at anybody else, because we do it too. So, as I've said before, it exists in the Northeast as well. You know, it doesn't make it right anywhere that it happens.
Yeah.
But it exists everywhere. It's prejudice.
It's very true. Because we're talking about...
Classism takes the form of casteism, you know, takes the form of xenophobia.
Yeah.
There are all these ways in which it plays out. But
Completely to adding to what Nick is saying, the discrimination is everywhere.
Yeah.
We're talking about communities, you know, within the same community, within the Hindu community, there are so many, you know,
Varns and
Varnas, you know, upper class, lower class, caste system. हमारे मुंबई में नहीं है वो अंधेरी ईस्ट में रहती है हम अंधेरी वेस्ट में रहते हैं
वेस्ट
अरे ये बैंड्रा वाले कुलाबा वाले अरे ये बैंडर में रहता है यार
अरे डोंबिवली नो बट यू नो इफ आई मे ऐड एक्चुअली टू व्हाट निक एंड विनय फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल व्हाट रियली स्टूड फॉर मी एंड स्टूड आउट अबाउट द स्क्रिप्ट इज यू नो ही बिकॉज़ ही इज That's his reality as well. It comes from a place of authenticity and it's such a balanced writing because as you said, it's not like really us versus them story. I mean, there is discrimination, but he actually shows the underlying, the subtle discrimination that happens within the community. Like how my character is Nepali and there is a little bit of, you know, chatter about, does she belong to us or is she the outsider, you know? And as Vinay was saying that, I think as human beings, we are always trying to be divisive. This whole thing of us versus them and having this, you know, putting the them as the enemy for whatever reason, you know, and in terms of color, race, religion, caste, class, gender, you name it and there is, you know. So we always somehow just keep looking at it. Unfortunately, the times we live in now, is just becoming more and more separatist and divisive, you know, unfortunately. And that's why I think it's not a good thing that Akune is more relevant today than it was before. But it's true, you know, it's just so much, the divisive forces are so strong around us.
This is in particular to the actors here. Obviously, just profession mein hai, how you look makes a lot of difference, okay? How you fit into a particular role. And there has been a lot of talk lately Saan ki aankh mein about younger women playing older women when already there are very few roles written for them. Yeah, the whole controversy that happened with Mary Kom. where do you guys, I mean, have you lost work because of the way you look? And where do you stand on this debate of if it's a role for someone from the Northeast, then you should get an actor from the Northeast to play it and not, you know, not get into the whole mold of makeup and trying to look as Northeast as possible?
Sometime it really breaks my heart. I was just talking to Tenzin, who's another actor from Makuni, who plays Shayani's boyfriend in the film. And I was like, Tenzin, if we looked Indian enough, is what I said. Like, I was so frustrated. I was like, if we looked Indian enough, we would be working, right? He was like, yeah, man, I agree to that. So it is disheartening a lot of time. It's a long struggle for me. It's been a long journey to be recognized, to be, you know, to be out there, still be there, and, you know, to be seen and to be doing and to live a dignified life. It's not been easy, Stuti, and I would like to be, ideally, this is my intention, I'm setting in every single day that I should be, or anybody should be, cast for their talent. Yes, features, casting, obviously, like, you know, if you're writing about a UP boy, like, you can't be getting somebody from a South Indian, or, like, no, it's not justified. But I want it to be, like, beyond our features, beyond, you know, all these cultural differences that we have, and should be cast majorly on the basis of talent.
In the 70s, forget about now, where there's this huge exposition to to what the Northeast is, etc., because of internet and so on and so forth. In the 70s, we hardly knew about the Northeast, and yet there was Danny Denzongpa, who was playing all these roles. Of the villain in some gang somewhere in the, you know, deep in, you know, in monarchy, and so on and so forth. He was doing all of that. And why was that? Because at some point, and I haven't really studied his, you know, his trajectory, but at some point there was an acceptance of that face, and it wasn't seen as a face that was East Asian. It wasn't seen as a face that was different. And so he became accepted. And that's easy to happen. I mean, it's difficult, but I'm saying it's not difficult for it to happen in people's minds. It just needs you just need to give, you know, for the opportunity to present itself. And that's
and
where...
And also feed them with different stories, And so I think...
Yes.
You know, what you were asking about casting somebody from Northeast, and I know, again, there has been so much conversation during Mericom and stuff. Again, I understand it's a business, and if you have to mount a big film, you need a star and things like that. And I understand all of that. And also, an actor is an actor. But if you fit the look, then I think you can sort of pass off. And I was very nervous and conscious of the fact that I play a Northeastern, but I'm the only person out of the cast who's
not
from
the
Northeast.
And also the accent, don't forget the accent. Can you talk like that? I just found that accent very
Main proper Northeast se hu jamalone. And I mean, guys, ki bhagwan thori na hu. Yeah, it's very difficult right now. Like, I have to come in
that. That was.
They also, you know, all of them had to work a little on their characters, except for Vinay. Vinay, of course, was a natural. You know,
natural Kharoos, daily
He was a Kharoos who was, you know, biased and, you know, all of that thing. And I know Vinay, so I like, you know.
Nevertheless, thank you so much, guys. All the best for the film. I'm sure it will be loved. You guys were amazing.
Thank you so much, Stuti. I love talking to you every time. Thank you.